In this tutorial, I am going to show you how to download your Windows for your virtual machine. You have to go to this link. I will give this link below in the description box. And when you go to this link, you will able to view this page, and you will have you can see this virtual machine. You can download Windows 7 and Windows 10 for your virtual machines. For example, if you are using VirtualBox or VMware in Windows or Mac, Hyper-V, for any virtual machines you want to get that image, you can download using this official website. The restriction is it will expire 90 days, but you can do the snapshot of it so that you can reuse that same image. When you download this, and after you power on your virtual machine, you have to give this password for the user. What you can do, you have to, for example, I am downloading Windows 10, and you can select the platform, VMware or whatever it may be, and you can download this. After clicking download, I have already downloaded, that is why it is saying it is duplicated. After downloading it, you can view the zip image. You can get the file in the terms of zip. What you have to do, you should not give the extract here command. You have to give the 7-zip. It will extract all the files inside the zip file. So if you do this extract here, it will extract only one file. This file only will be extracted. So you have to extract using 7-zip. When you extract this, you will get this folder, and you have to go inside this folder, and you can view all the three images. What you have to do, you have to double click this OVA file. When you double click this, it will get opened into the VMware. Suppose if you want to upgrade, means you can also upgrade your VMware. I have already upgraded it. For example, I am going to do it again. You can store the disk in the appropriate location, and you can create a folder here. Then you can give the symbol name Windows 10. After that, you have to do import. It will take little time to import, so I am going to pause the video. After importing it to the VMware, you will see the page like this. You can upgrade this virtual machine. You have to click this and click next. Here the workstation, it is showing as Windows 12. I'm using VMware 15, so I'm upgrading it. So click next. Alter this virtual machine, next, and click finish. This will upgrade to VMware 15. Then close this, and if you want to edit this virtual machine, you can go to this settings, edit virtual machines, and based upon your RAM capacity you can increase or decrease your RAM, and as well as you can increase or decrease your processors. That's it. We will go with the default settings and we will click power on this virtual machine. It will directly take you to the user login window. So it will take little time to open. So it has directly taken to the user login window, and you can log in using the password. That is, you can see the official website for that. See the password, capital P, then everything is in small, and this is not O, it is 0. Then RD, and this is exclamatory sentence. Go to the window and give the password capital P A S S W O, not W O, W 0 RD, and give the exclamatory sentence. You can see the password. Click. Take you to the Windows login page. After login you have to activate that Windows. It is trial period only. After activating you can get the snapshot of it. You can come back using that snapshot even though if your license is expired. Using that snapshot, the time where we will get that snapshot, it will restore in that time period. So it will restore from the initial stage itself. You can see the what you have to do, all that things here, it is written this desktop. You can see the activation or how to activate your Windows 10. What you have to do, you have to search for the command line, put cmd, can right click, you have to run as administrator. Then you have to give the command slngr auto. slngr / auto. This will activate your Windows. It will will ask for confirmation, you can give OK so that it will activate your Windows. The most important thing is you need a network address, you need a internet for this activation. How you can activate means you can see the settings. The default settings will be that network adapter you will use is NAT. With the help of this, it will get the internet from your connected physical internet connection, so that it will get activated. After activating, you have to go to this machine and you have to right click and you have to take a snapshot, and you have to take snapshot. After activating your Windows, you have to do this because it will restore when the 90 days is expired. It will restore to this position. If you haven't activated the Windows and taking the snapshot, then you have to again activate it. So you have to make sure after activating the Windows, you have to give the snapshot. You can give the snapshot when your license have expired. You can click this revert to snapshot, snapshot 1. When you click this, it will take you to this initial position. You can see here, you are here. When you take your snapshot, it will restore back. So 90 days will be extended with the help of this.